गुड मॉर्निंग डियर फ्रेंड्स. इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी कंप्लीटेड रिगार्डिंग हिप्नोटिक एंड सेडेटिव चैप्टर. नाउ फ्रॉम टुडे वी स्टार्ट विद द नेक्स्ट चैप्टर, दैट इज एपिलेप्सी एंड एंटी एपिलेप्टिक ड्रग्स और दिस एपिलेप्सी इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज कन्वर्जेंस एंड एंटी कन्वर्जेंट ड्रग. One and the same. Sometimes they will be asked, what is epilepsy or what is convulsion? It is one and the same. Or define and classify anti-epileptic or anti-convulsion drug. In Marathi, we call as fit. Epilepsy means what? Fit any. Fit etar. Baraj patient will be going in the same fit etar. Baraj to panna, baraj patient na fit etar. Now, what is epilepsy? Epilepsy, it is a neurological disorder. Epilepsy is a neurological disorder which is characterized by recurrent transition seizures attack. The patient la fit eta recurrently kai kai vela nantar kay ata patient la recurrently there is a transition seizures attack take place in patient. It is occurs due to excessive stimulation of central nervous system. When central nervous system stimulation takes place, that leads to process abnormal condition in patient. Abnormally there is a seizures attack, convulsions attack takes place in patient, which is mainly characterized by symptoms that there is a sudden reversible loss of consciousness takes place in patient. The patient suddenly beshuddha ho jata, there is a sudden reversible loss of consciousness occurs. Tumhi jar fit aale patient kadhi baghitla asel tar fit aalna patient इमिजिएट का तो सडन गोज अंडर लॉस ऑफ कॉन्शियसनेस बेशुद्ध हो. सेकंड थिंग प्रोड्यूसेस वायलेंट स्पास्मोडिक कॉन्ट्रैक्शंस ऑफ मसल्स. ये तो पेशेंट हाथ पाए झटकते, दैट इज वायलेंट स्पास्मोडिक कॉन्ट्रैक्शंस ऑफ मसल्स एंड आल्सो प्रोड्यूसेस हाइपर एक्टिविटी ऑफ आईज. ये तो पेशेंट डोले फिरते होते हैं. दिस सिम्टम्स तुम्ही जर फिट आलेले पेशेंट अगदी तसे तर इट प्रोड्यूसेस रिवर्सिबल लॉस ऑफ जो सडन बेशुद्ध होतो, हात पाय झटकतो, वायलेंट स्पास्मिक कॉन्ट्रॅक्शन्स ऑफ मसल एंड ऑल्सो प्रोसेस हायपर ऍक्टिव्हिटी ऑफ आईज, म्हणजे तो डोळे फिरून जातो. एंड देयर इज अ कंटिन्युअस ट्रान्झिशन सीजर्स अटॅक टेक प्लेस इन पेशंट, दॅट डिसऑर्डर दॅट इज कॉल्ड एज एपिलेप्सी और दॅट इज कॉल्ड एज कन्वल्जन. सो समटाइम देयर विल बी आस्क्ड व्हाट इज कन्वल्जन और व्हाट इज एपिलेप्सी. सो यू अंडरस्टँड दॅट इट इज अ न्यूरोलॉजिकल डिसऑर्डर. Nerve disease occurs due to excessive stimulation of central nervous system. It mainly shows transition seizures attack in patient. And the major symptoms found in epilepsy or in convulsion that there is a reversible loss of consciousness, violent spasmodic contractions of muscles and hyperactivity of eyes. That group of common symptoms that is called as epilepsy or convulsion. Now what are the pathophysiology or neurophysiology of epilepsy? Epilepsy is a reason kind of pathophysiology or also called as neurophysiology or reasons for epilepsy. ये type of patient में जो epileptic attack होता है, ये जगह seizures attack patient में देता है, ये कैसा होता है? What is the pathophysiology? और what is the neurophysiology of epilepsy? और also called as reasons for epilepsy. Epileptic attack कैसा होता है? Then mainly there are three reasons responsible to produce epileptic attack in patient. First thing, that nerve impulses propagated in brain in a synchronous pattern or in increasing pattern and electrical potential is close to zero. Whenever there is a hyperactivity take place, nerve impulses propagation occurs in brain in increasing pattern or in a rise pattern, that electrical potential is close to zero. Any processes which damages or irritating gray matter of the brain, thereby affecting gray matter of brain and produces either activation or inactivation of neuron, means neuron function disturbances take place. That leads to causes sudden excessive abnormal electrical discharge in brain. Because of activation or inactivation of neuron, there is a sudden abnormal electrical discharge take place in brain. If this electrical discharge remains localized, then it is called as localized epilepsy or also called as the partial epilepsy. whatever the abnormal electrical discharge which is due to activation or inactivation of neuron, neuron function disturb झाल्या नाही, जे abnormal electrical focus discharge मध्ये होणार आहे ब्रेन मध्ये, that if this discharge remains localized, then it is called as localized epilepsy or it is called as the partial epilepsy. And if it is spreading and affecting whole cerebrum, then it is called as generalized epilepsy. There are two types of epilepsy. According to what? According to the release of abnormal electrical discharge, there are two types, localized or partial epilepsy, where the abnormal discharge remains localized. And if it is spreading and affecting whole cerebrum, then it is called as generalized epilepsy. So this is the first reason responsible for attack of epilepsy or convulsions, like because of dysfunctioning of nerve or activation or inactivation of neuron. Another thing, that imbalances between inhibitory transmitters of GABA level, that is gamma amino glutaric acid level. Whenever there is an imbalance that takes place in inhibitory transmitters such as GABA level, that also leads to process epilepsy or convulsions attack. And third one, that is selective calcium channel blockers are also involved in epileptic attack. So mainly there are three pathophysiological or neurophysiological reasons responsible to produce either epileptic attack or convulsions attack in patient. One, that is nerve impulses propagation, that is activation or inactivation of neuron, that causes abnormal electrical discharge. If this abnormal electrical discharge remains localized, then it is called as localized or partial epilepsy. If it is spreading and affecting whole cerebrum, then it is called as generalized epilepsy. This is the first reason. Second, that is imbalances between inhibitory transmitters like GABA, that is gamma amino glutaric acid level disturbances, also leads to process epileptic attack. And third reason, that is calcium channel blockers are also involved in epilepsy or in convulsions attack. So sometimes they may ask, what is epilepsy or what is convulsion? You neurophysiology of epilepsy or explain pathophysiology of epilepsy. So you are supposed to explain these three reasons for epileptic attack or convulsions attack. Now the next point, what are the types of epilepsy? Sometimes they may ask full question, that right, or explain various types of epilepsy. So you understand regarding epilepsy. Now the next point, that is types of epilepsy. Now this epilepsy type classified into, there are two ways for classification of epilepsy. One way, that is according to the release of abnormal electrical discharge. J abnormal electrical discharge release of the, according to that we already completed here, that there are two types. One, that is to be called as partial or localized epilepsy, and second one, that is to be called as generalized epilepsy. Partial or localized epilepsy, where there is abnormal electrical discharge remains localized, then it is partial or localized epilepsy. If it is spreading and affecting whole cerebrum, then it is called as generalized epilepsy. So this is the first way for types of epilepsy, that is according to the release of abnormal electrical discharge in patient. Second way, that is according to the symptoms. Whatever the symptoms found in patient, according to this there are various types. In that first one, that is called as the grand mal epilepsy. Second one, that is petit mal epilepsy. Third type, that is called as the temporal lobe epilepsy. Then fourth type, that is focal cortical or Jacksonian type of epilepsy. Then next type, minor or status epilepticus condition. And last type, that is called as the myoclonical type of epilepsy. Majorly there are six types according to the symptoms. Sometimes they may ask full question that explain various types of epilepsy. So there are two ways for classification of epilepsy. One way, that is according to the release of abnormal electrical discharge. Whatever the electrical abnormal focus released because of activation or inactivation of neuron, there are two types, partial or localized epilepsy, and second one is generalized epilepsy. Second way for classification of epilepsy, that is according to symptoms. According to symptoms, these are the six types. First type, that is grand mal epilepsy, petit mal epilepsy, temporal lobe epilepsy, then focal cortical or Jacksonian type of epilepsy, then minor or status epilepticus condition, and last one is myoclonical type of epilepsy. Let us see first, that is grand mal epilepsy. In case of grand mal epilepsy, there is a sudden reversible loss of consciousness occurs in patient. Whenever a patient suddenly visual loss of consciousness takes place, this loss of consciousness remains for few minutes or few hours also. In some patient, maybe for half an hour or maybe up to 1 hour also. And when patient awaken, he has no recollection of preceding event. ये तो कसा विशुद्ध पड़ता, काय झालं हे काही लक्षात येत नाही. That type of epilepsy, that is called as grandmal epilepsy. That there is a sudden loss of consciousness in patient. Patient suddenly विशुद्ध होतो and maybe for few minutes or few hours also. And when he awaken, he has no recollection of preceding event. And that type of epilepsy, that is called as grandmal epilepsy. Second type, paroxysmal epilepsy, there is also sudden loss of consciousness but remain for few seconds or for few minutes. Thoda kaal tak patient patient ho and he shows no any facial expression but he may blink eyelid, fakt dore band chalu karto, he may blink eyelid and there is no any facial expression but there is a sudden loss of consciousness remain for few seconds or for few minutes. That type of epilepsy, that is called as paroxysmal epilepsy. Then third type, that is temporal lobe epilepsy. In this type of epilepsy, there is an absence of convulsion. Convulsions attack patient for the 8th line. But there is an altering emotional behavioral activity of the patient. In case of temporal lobe epilepsy, there is an absence of convulsion. Convulsion can seizures attack threshold patient with an osteo. But there is an altering emotional activity of the patient. That type of epilepsy, that is called as temporal lobe epilepsy. Then next type, that is focal cortical or Jacksonian type of epilepsy, where there is a convergence of single limb or group of muscles, jerking movement takes place in patient. Hatpai jama jadak ho. That time there is a single limb, jerking movement occurs to the group of muscles. That type of epilepsy, that is called as focal cortical or Jacksonian type of epilepsy. Then next type, that is minor or status epilepticus condition, where there is a sudden loss of consciousness take place in patient within short interval of time. Thoda thoda vel nantar, kai vel nantar 2 minutasathi patient beshuddh hoil, kai vel nantar parat 10-15 minutanantar parat beshuddh hoil. Sudden, there is a sudden loss of consciousness take place repeatedly within short interval period of time, and if this loss of consciousness remain as it is, it may lead to affecting the brain damage also. There is a brain damage may take place, and that type of epilepsy, that is called as minor or status epilepticus condition. And last type, that is myoclonical type of epilepsy, where there is a certain symptoms already we discussed, that produces loss of consciousness, reversible loss of consciousness, hyperactivity of eyes if patient dure film deto, and there is a violent spasmodic contractions of muscle if patient hyperactive. That group of common symptoms, that is called as myoclonical type of epilepsy. So these are the various types of epilepsy. Sometimes most of the time we can explain various types of epilepsy, full question. So you supposed to explain that there are two ways for classification of epilepsy, that one way according to the release of abnormal electrical discharge, that you understand partial or localized, where abnormal electrical discharge remains localized into the brain portion. Then it is partial or localized. If it is affecting, spreading and affecting more cerebrum, then it called as generalized. Then you understand, according to symptom, these are the six types of epilepsy. Sometimes they will be asked, what is grand mal epilepsy? Classify the drug using grand mal epilepsy, or mention the drug using grand mal epilepsy. So you understand various types of epilepsy according to symptoms. Now, in order to treat these various types of epilepsy, maybe grand mal, paroxysmal, temporal, or any type of epilepsy, whatever the drugs used in treatment of epilepsy, the drug that is called as anti-epileptic drugs. So the next point, that is anti-epileptic drug, or also called as anti-convulsion drug. Anti-epileptic or anti-convulsion, that is those drugs used in treatment of epilepsy or in convulsions, these drugs are GABA agonists. Remember that these are the GABA agonists, that is gamma aminone butyric acid agonist, as well as these are the sodium channel blockers, and therefore affecting release of abnormal electrical discharge and also affecting spreading of abnormal discharge in brain, and thereby used in treatment of epilepsy or convulsions, therefore called as anti-epileptic drug or एंटी कन्वर्जेंट ड्रग्स. समटाइम्स व्हेन वी आस्क फुल क्लासिफिकेशन दैट डिफाइन एंटी एपिलेप्टिक ड्रग क्लासिफाइड विद एग्जांपल और डिफाइन एंटी कन्वर्जेंट ड्रग क्लासिफाइड विद एग्जांपल. सो इट इज वन एंड द सेम दैट एंटी एपिलेप्टिक और एंटी कन्वर्जेंट्स आर दोस ड्रग यूज्ड इन ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ एपिलेप्सी और यूज्ड इन ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ कन्वर्जेंट्स thereby abolish or diminish or block the release of abnormal electrical discharge in brain. These are GABA agonists, that is gamma aminobutyric acid agonists, as well as these are sodium channel blocker and therefore called as anti-epileptic or anti-convulsant drug. Now these drugs are classified into different types. In that first type, that is barbiturates. Barbiturates already completed under hypnotic and sedative. Particularly phenobarbital, butabarbital, mefobarbital, these drugs are used as anti-epileptic drug under barbiturate category. Second type, that is hydantoin derivatives. Example, phenantoin, mefantoin, ethantoin. These drugs chemically, basically contain hydantoin nucleus and therefore called as hydantoin derivatives. Example, phenantoin, mefantoin and ethantoin. Third type, that is called as succinamide derivative, chemically containing succinamide derivative, example phensuximide, ethosuximide and methosuximide. Then next type, that is called as oxazolidine diamine derivative, chemically containing oxazolidine diamine nucleus, that is oxazolidine diamine derivative, example trimethadione and paramethadione. Next type, that is called as immunostimulant derivative, chemically it contain immunostimulant derivatives, example carbamazepine. This drug also used as anti-epileptic agent. And last type, that is miscellaneous drug, example diazepam and sodium valproate, that is salt of sodium valproic acid, also used in treatment of epilepsy or in convulsion. So this is what, this is full classification of anti-epileptic or anti-convulsion drug. Instead of asking sometimes, they may ask full question that on types of epilepsy, what is epilepsy, types of epilepsy, neurophysiology or pathophysiology of epilepsy, or there may be question that what are anti-epileptic drugs classified with example, or what are anti-convulsant drugs classified with example. So these are the six types, that is barbiturates compound, phenobarbital, butabarbital, mefobarbital. Hydantoin derivatives, example phenantoin, mefantoin, ethantoin. Succinamide derivatives, example phensuximide, ethosuximide, methosuximide. Oxazolidine diamine derivatives, example trimethadione and paramethadione. Then immunostimulant derivatives, example carbamazepine. And last one is miscellaneous drugs like diazepam and sodium valproate. But here you remember that first two types, that is barbiturates and hydantoin derivatives, are the drug of choice in treatment of grand mal epilepsy. Why? Succinamides and oxazolidine diamine derivatives are the drug of choice in treatment of petit mal epilepsy. While immunostimulant drugs are used in variety of epilepsy. If there is a complex set of symptoms or infection, then our diagnosis of symptoms is going to be difficult. Then the drug which is used in epilepsy, that is called as carbamazepine. All these drugs used in today's practice also, as with the separate drug market for the epileptic patient or feet allergy patient. So sometimes they will ask, name any two or three drugs used in treatment of grand mal epilepsy. So remember that barbiturate derivatives like phenobarbital, butabarbital, mefobarbital or hydantoin derivatives, phenantoin, mefantoin, ethantoin. These are the drug of choice in treatment of grand mal epilepsy. Why? In petit mal epilepsy, particularly succinamide derivative, like phensuximide, ethosuximide, methosuximide, while oxazolidine diamine derivatives like trimethadione and paramethadione. These are the drug of choice in petit mal epilepsy, isn't it? So classification is very important. Now here most important question which is generally asked in examination regarding new reason, then why phenobarbital and phenantoin, these drugs given in combination in treatment of grand mal epilepsy? Remember this. Why phenobarbital and phenantoin drug given in combination in treatment of grand mal epilepsy? These two drug combination with cardiazepam. I think in the last lecture under hypnotic and sedative, we also completed that phenobarbital and phenantoin are the drug of choice in treatment of grand mal epilepsy. Already you understand what is grand mal epilepsy, that there is a sudden loss of consciousness in patient when patient awaken he has no recollection of preceding event काय कशामध्ये पेशंट झाला काय झालं हे पेशंटला लक्षात येत नाही दैट ग्रुप ऑफ कॉमन सिम्पटम दैट इज कॉल्ड एज ग्रैनुलोमेटोलाइसिस नाउ व्हाई फिनोबार्बिटोल एंड फिनेंडोइन दिस टू ड्रग गिवन इन कॉम्बिनेशन हियर यू रिमेंबर दैट मैकेनिज्म ऑफ एक्शन फिनोबार्बिटोल दैट ड्रग बिलोंगिंग टू बार्बिट्यूरेट कैटेगरी इट इज ए गाबा एगोनिस्ट फिनोबार्बिटोल दैट इज एक्टिंग एज ए गाबा एगोनिस्ट While phenytoin that is used as sodium channel blocker, remember this. That phenobarbital acting as a GABA agonist, while phenytoin acting as sodium channel blocker. When phenobarbital drug given alone to the patient, it affecting the release of abnormal electrical discharge in brain. This is after bagita. Because of activation or inactivation of neuron, there is abnormally release of electrical discharge take place in brain. So that abnormal electrical discharge release is going to be affected by phenobarbital, but may not affecting spreading in cerebrum. That when phenytoin given, this phenytoin may not affecting the release of abnormal discharge, but it affecting the spreading of abnormal discharge. If the abnormal electrical discharge release are the brain, then the block spread karayche kaam je hogare ki kon block kare phenytoin. It has a sodium channel. Blocker and thereby to overcome the side effect of phenobarbital that it affecting only release but may not affecting spreading. While phenytoin may not affecting release but affecting spreading. So to overcome the side effect of both the drug, these type of drug given in combination in treatment of granular epilepsy. Even another mechanism that sodium it mainly affecting or decreases the sodium level. Sodium concentration, sodium entering in blood brain affected and thereby it decreases PTP level that is post tetanic potential level decreases. Stability of neuron is going to be affected. Because of what? Because of decreasing the level of PTP that is post tetanic potentiation level decreases due to blocking of sodium entry and because of these two reasons it is used in combination in treatment of granular epilepsy. So here there are two questions. Why phenobarbital and phenytoin given in combination? Okay, so these are the two reasons. Or they may be asked describe mechanism of action of phenobarbital and phenytoin. So mechanism of action is same that phenobarbital drug acting as a GABA agonist, while phenytoin acting as sodium channel blocker. Means phenytoin drug, this drug affecting the release of abnormal electrical discharge, while phenytoin drug affecting spreading and second reason or second mechanism that it decreases neuronal sodium concentration and when neuronal sodium concentration decreases it decreases PTP level maintaining stability of neuron and that is post tetanic potentiation level decreases and thereby used as anti epileptic drug in treatment of granular epilepsy. So these are the two questions. Sometimes they will ask why this combination given or instead of this they will ask explain mechanism of action of phenobarbital and phenytoin in granular epilepsy. So remember the mechanism of action. Now here another important point that they will ask mention dose, route of administration and one important is the phenobarbital and phenytoin. Phenytoin is the most important one. So phenobarbital drug used in the dose of 30 to 60 milligram thrice a day, three times a day. Maximum dose that is 180 milligram. Trade name for phenobarbital tablet that is gardiner tablet, gardiner injections available in market. These drug 30 milligram, 60 milligram tablet available in market maximum 3 times a day given to the patient that is up to 180 milligram and trade name for phenobarbital tablet that is gardiner tablet by oral route, gardiner injection by IV. Similarly, phenytoin it is used in the dose of 100 to 400 milligram per day by oral route of administration. Treatment given here about for 6 months up to 1 year also depending on the symptom. So here this is important only repeatedly they may ask mention dose, route of administration and one important use of phenytoin. So phenytoin that is used in the dose of 100 milligram tablet, trade name that is Yptoin tablet, available in market, 100 milligram tablets available in market. So maximum depending on the symptom maximum dose that is up to 400 milligram given to the patient by oral route. So 100 to 400 milligram per day. And trade name that is Yptoin or Berendine. So then we must mention dose, route of administration and one important of phenobarbital and phenytoin. Now here these drugs are very less used like mefentanil and methentanil. These are the grand mal epilepsy drugs. But because of its side effect that mainly affecting the blood structure and thereby process or melanocytosis or aplastic anemia, thrombocytopenia. These are the side effect of this drug and therefore these are less used. Why succinamide and oxazolidine and derivative, these are the drug of choice in petit mal epilepsy. Out of this, felsuximide is widely used in petit mal epilepsy. What is petit mal? Already you know that there is also sudden loss of consciousness and this loss of consciousness remains for few seconds or for few minutes and there is no any facial expression but you may blink eyelid. That term that is called as petit mal epilepsy, where the drug of choice are felsuximide, ethosuximide, methotrexate. These drug given in the dose of 0.2 to 0.5 gram in divided doses, that is 200 to 500 milligram by oral route of administration. Here you remember that paramethadone that is also be used in petit mal epilepsy, but it is very less used because of its side effect that paramethadone produces day blindness. Day blindness or also called as photophobia. Sometimes there will be asked mention major side effect of paramethadone. Paramethadone it majorly produces photophobia or day blindness. This is the major side effect. That is glare effect or glare phenomenon. Bright object may not be seen by the patient. That effect that is called as photophobia or day blindness. And to overcome this side effect, always advises given to the patient to wear dark colored glasses goggles. So sometimes you may ask even in hospital and clinical pharmacy that what are your advices given to paramethadone drug treatment. So the advice is given that is to wear dark colored glasses goggles in order to overcome the side effect that is called as day blindness or photophobia effect. Similarly, immunostimulant derivative that is carbamazepine, this drug used if the complex set of symptoms found in patient. If the epileptic type apparently lakshat yet nasel, complex set of symptoms found in patient or type of epilepsy is going to be unknown, then the drug which is used that is called as carbamazepine. Trade name that is tegretol tablet. This tegretol tablet available in market generally given again in the dose of 100 to 400 milligram. 100 milligram, 200 milligram tablets available in market. Maximum dose up to 400 milligram by oral route administration. So this carbamazepine is used. Similarly, diazepam that is hypnotic and sedative drug, always given to epileptic patient in order to produce a calming effect. Sodium valproic acid, that is valproic acid, sodium salts, that is also be effective along with carbamazepine or along with phenobarbital and phenytoin. This drug given to the patient. So this is regarding anti-epileptic drug or anti-convulsant drug. Here you remember major classification, types of epilepsy, pathophysiology or neurophysiology of epilepsy, what is epilepsy, isn't it? And doses of phenobarbital, phenytoin, carbamazepine, isn't it? Then what is the due reason why phenobarbital, phenytoin used in combination or mechanism of action of phenobarbital and phenytoin? One more question they will be asked in the examination. What is status epilepticus condition and due its treatment? A question generally which are also what is status epilepticus and what due its treatment. Already we completed that in status epilepticus that is nothing but there is a repeated occurrence of reversible loss of consciousness within short period of time. In short interval, the patient beshuddha hod raha. Beshuddha, 2-5 minute under beshuddha hoto, parat recover hoto, parat beshuddha hoto, within short interval period. There is a repeatedly attack of reversible loss of consciousness in this patient. And if this patient may not be treated, that may lead to process brain damage. And therefore, that condition that is called as status epilepticus condition. Generally, the treatment using status epilepticus, immediately there is a diazepam injection given to the patient in the dose of 10 mg by IV. Then another treatment used that is clonazepam given in the dose of 1 to 2 mg. And third treatment that is phenobarbital drug used in the dose of 100 to 200 mg by IV also. So this is the line of treatment which is used in status epilepticus patient, that diazepam drug, clobamazine drug and phenobarbital drug in the dose of 100 to 200 mg given by IV. So then you may ask what is status epilepticus and treatment. So you supposed to remember this. These are the important questions under anti-epileptic or anti-convulsant. So today we finish full chapter that is epilepsy and anti-epileptic drug. So next time we see psychopharmacological drug. You complete the notes and thank you.